Here we're going to do a different example. Here we have a 200 megahertz and a 500 megahertz RF input. So we're doing a dual band system with a common 70 megahertz output. We're doing a high side mixer for mixer number one and a low side LO for mixer number two. And we can see how we can select each of the mixers here. And what we see is there's a spur-free region from 45 to 70 megahertz. So we could use that area effectively for our design. Unlike WhatIF, spreadsheets typically do not keep track of every spectral product generated and propagated throughout the system, account easily for non-ideal device behavior, spur tables, many harmonics, utilize vendor spur table data directly in the simulation from the library. They don't present the data interactively in a convenient graphical format and keep the data in the same workspace as a system tool. We can use the design we've created in WhatIF directly now to implement our design. WhatIF makes the process fast and easy. Easy to learn, it takes minutes versus hours to make changes and look at what-if type situations. And imagine over-designing a system to overcome a hidden performance flaw caused by poor choice of frequencies or the use of idealized elements. Once the RF architecture is completed, the designs will typically be passed to someone to implement the various pieces of the down converter. In this case, we'll show how to use the Genesis synthesis to create one of the filters directly from a behavioral model. It can be done either as an op-amp or a distributed structure or with capacitors and inductors as an LC filter. Because of the RF frequency being in 200 megahertz, we're just going to use a passive RF filter. Here we're going to design the filter. You can see you just directly on the filter hit passive generation, and based upon the parameters it will synthesize a filter for you. No other action is required. And you have a filter, and it shows the response right on the screen, and the filter is immediately implemented. Here's showing the broadband response at the output. Now that we're satisfied with a Spectrasys design, we want to export the design to ADS for more complex simulation, such as modulated carrier analysis. We may want to propagate real signals through it. We may want to do HDL co-simulation or MATLAB co-simulation. We may want to link it to instruments. We may want to co-simulate with the electromagnetic simulator, such as momentum. We may want to simulate with 3D EM simulator results, such as from EDMS or ADMS for antennas. So the process for passing it up to ADS, this is our Spectrasys design with our broadband source. File, export, schematic to ADS. It will point out that there are certain parameters which are not going to export, such as the wideband source, which does not have an equivalent in ADS. The resultant circuit in ADS is displayed here. You'll see the broadband source shows up as a blocked out icon, and you can add your own source in there. But you'll see also the filter, remember what we had synthesized the filter, is a standard lumped element filter representation is in ADS. All the equations are passed over, so it makes it very easy to pass designs up to the higher level. What I did here was a very quick ADS chirp radar simulation, where I had a 10 megahertz wide radar at 200 megahertz propagating through our system and looking at the output at 70 megahertz. This is looking at the envelope, spectral envelope display, both in the time and frequency domain. I believe this is a 30 megahertz wide spectrum, and you can see the some distortion in the Chirp radar signal due to the bandwidth limitations on the radio. Next, we want to show the ability to do an ADS MATLAB Chirp radar co-simulation. Here I have a MATLAB-based Chirp source, which I'm processing through my through some various components to add things such as noise and delay and attenuation to the signal. I'm then processing that into that our down converter, and then taking the output of the down converter and processing it back into MATLAB again to post-process the data. And we can see some of the results both at the input and output. There's a receiver input spectrum and time domain waveform. And then at the output, we can see the output waveform with a higher power level, obviously, and we can see the pulse or the radar waveform has been distorted because of the limited bandwidth of the signal. So in conclusion, in this presentation, we've seen several ways of these tools working together to design and verify a system. Three key Genesis products that are available, which are significant value to an RF system architect. Spectrasys, which allows us to do spectral propagation and root cause analysis. We can do budget implementation. It's very easy to use and implement designs. And we can always upload those designs to ADS if we want to later. WhatIF allows us to do frequency planning and mixer spurious analysis very, very quickly and do trade-offs and what-if type situations. The synthesis allows us to quickly create filters and other networks. These products help you to avoid implementing a costly or flawed system design. They allow you to enter your design flow in ADF with some of the design already done. So Spectrasys, WhatIF, and the synthesized designs can be directly ported into ADS for further simulation. Thank you for attending this seminar. For additional information, please contact your local Agilent ESOF sales engineer or use one of the reference websites shown below.